Hello students, welcome once again in the video lecture series for class 12th. In our last lecture, we discussed production function and now we are continuing it. Actually, production function is the physical relation between the units of input and output by using various combinations of two inputs under a given state of technology. We also discussed isoquant, which is the alternative of production function. If you remember, isoquant is a curve that shows different combinations of two factors resulting in same level of output. Today, we will elaborate the concept of types of production function. Basically, production function is of two types: production function in short run and production function in long run. In short run production function, law of variable proportion is applicable, and in the long run production function, law of returns to scale is applicable. First, we will understand the law applicable in short run. The law of variable proportions is also known as the law of diminishing returns. It is also known as the law of returns to a factor. This law explains the physical input-output relationship, not the financial relationship. This law states that the units of output can be increased by varying the quantity of one input only. As we earlier said, that this law is applicable in the short run, when all the factors of production cannot be increased or decreased simultaneously. For example, we cannot build a plant or dismantle a plant in short run. Generally, labor is assumed as variable factor in short run. This short run law is based on certain assumptions, which are as follows. Number one assumption is that the state of technology is given and remains unchanged, because if there is any improvement in the technology, then marginal and average product may rise instead of falling. Second assumption of short run law is that only physical quantities of inputs and outputs are considered and not the economic profitability in monetary terms. The third assumption is that only one factor is variable. This law does not apply to cases when all factors of production are proportionately changed to increase in unit of output. When all the factors are proportionately changed, law of returns to scale are applicable, which will be studied in long run. The fourth assumption behind short run law is that this law does not apply to those cases where factors must be used in some fixed proportionate to yield one unit of output. The law of variable proportions explains that as we increase the quantity of variable input, which is combined with other fixed input, the marginal physical productivity of the variable input must eventually decline. In other words, if we increase the unit of one input only, for example, units of labor, keeping units of other inputs fixed, when the state of technology is given and fixed, the result will be the increase in the units of output initially, but after a point, the increase in output by employing extra unit of labor will become less and less. Let us draw a four columnar table to explain this law. There are four columns. First column is for units of variable factor, that is units of labor, which are given from 1 to 13. Second column is for total product produced by labor. Third column is for average product. Average product equals to total product divided by number of variable input, that is labor. And fourth column is for marginal product. Marginal product equals to difference in total product upon difference in quantity of variable factor, that is input. Now it is the time to draw a curve. On x-axis, we will take the units of variable factor, and on y-axis, we will take the quantities of total product, average product and marginal product. This diagram can be divided into three stages. Stage 1 ends at fourth unit, where average product is maximum at 110 units, and also marginal product is equal to average product at this point. Second stage ends at 11th unit, where marginal product becomes 0 and total product is maximum and constant. After 11th unit, the third stage begins. Before understanding the three stages, first we should understand the three technical terms, and these three terms are total product, average product and marginal product. First is total product or total physical product. Actually, total product is the total output resulting from the efforts of all the factors of production combined together at any time. Total product varies with the quantity used of the variable factor. As is clear in the above table, that as we are employing more and more units of labor, initially total product rises at increasing rate, then rising but at decreasing rate, and eventually decline since 12th unit of labor is employed. Second term is average product or average physical product. It means the total product per unit of variable factor. The table shows that average product also, like total product, initially rises, reaches to its maximum, then declines, but both total product and average product remains positive because total and average can never be negative. Third term is marginal product or marginal physical product. It means change in total product per unit change in the quantity of variable factor. It also rises in starting, reaches to its maximum, and then starts to decline and becomes negative. Let's explain the three stages. Stage 1 is known as the law of increasing returns. In this stage, total product increases at an increasing rate, marginal product also rises and is maximum at the point corresponding to F, and average product goes on rising. From point F onwards, during the stage 1, the total product goes on rising but at diminishing rate. Marginal product falls but is positive, and the stage 1 ends where the average product curve reaches its highest point. Thus, in the first stage, average product curve rises throughout, whereas the marginal product curve first rises and then starts falling after reaching its maximum. It is to be noted that the marginal product, although starts declining, but remains greater than the average product throughout the stage, so that average product continues to rise. The reason behind this stage are, first, efficiency of variable factor, that is efficiency of labor increases. Second reason is labor becomes specialized, which increases its productivity. Third reason is fixed factor capital being fully utilized. Stage 2. Stage 2 is known as law of diminishing returns. In this stage, the total product continues to increase but at the diminishing rate until it reaches its maximum point where the second stage ends. In this stage, both marginal product and average product of the variable factor are diminishing but are positive. At the end of this stage, the marginal product of the variable factor is 0. Stage 2 is known as stage of diminishing returns because both the average and marginal product of the variable factor continuously fall during this stage. Reasons behind the second stage are, first, when the units of variable factor are further increased, the fixed factor gets exhausted and becomes inadequate comparative to the quantity of the variable factor. Second reason is that idle time of the laborers increase. Third reason is imperfect substitutability of one factor for another. Now comes the stage 3, law of negative returns. In this stage, total product declines, marginal product becomes negative, and average product is diminishing but positive. This stage is called as stage of negative returns, since the marginal product of the variable factor is negative during this stage. Reasons behind this third stage are, first, quantity of the variable factor becomes too excessive relative to the fixed factor, so that they come in each other's way, with the result that the total output falls instead of rising. Solution of this problem is that a reduction in the units of the variable factor can increase the total output. So, these were the three stages of law of variable proportions. Now, an important question here is, in which stage a rational producer will seek to produce, whether in stage 1 or in stage 2 or in stage 3? What will be your answer if you were a producer? I think you will never like to produce in stage 3, where marginal product of the variable factor is negative. You will also not produce in stage 1, because your marginal product is still positive and total product is also increasing, though at diminishing rate. I mean to say, a rational producer will like to add more variable factors to the fixed input. It is thus clear that a rational producer will never produce in stage 1 and stage 3. These stages are called as stages of economic absurdity or economic nonsense. A rational producer will always produce in stage 2, where both the marginal product and average product of the variable factor are diminishing but are positive. So, here ends the short run and its law. Now, the long run. With the law of returns to scale. In this section, we will study the behavior of output when all the factors of production can be changed. In this part, we will concentrate on the input-output relationship in the long run. No factors remain constant in the long run. All factors are variable here. Therefore, the firm can change its scale of operations. It is very important to understand the term scale of operations. A change in scale means that all factors of production are increased or decreased in the same proportion. Change in scale is different from changes in factor proportions. Actually, when a firm increases all inputs proportionately and simultaneously, there are three possibilities. First, that the total output increases more than proportionately. Second, that the total output increases proportionately. And third, that the total output increases less than proportionately. This law of returns to scale says that if given a certain combination of inputs producing a given output, all the inputs are increased in the same proportion and the output increase in the same proportion, returns to scale are constant. If output increases more than proportionately, these are increasing returns to scale. And thirdly, if output increases less than proportionately, there are decreasing returns to scale. We can understand this law with the help of an example. Let's draw a table. This is a 5-columnar table. In first column, there is units of capital. In the second column, there are units of labor. In the third column, there is percentage increase in both labor and capital, that is percentage increase in inputs. In fourth column, there is given total product. And in fifth column, there is given percentage increase in output. Students, we can see up to fourth unit, percentage increase in input is 100%, 50% and 33.3%. But percentage increase in output is 120%, 59% and 43%. I mean to say, up to 4 unit, there is first stage, law of increasing returns to scale. Output is increasing more than increase in input. At 5th unit of labor, percentage change in input is 25%. Also, the percentage change in output is 25. At 6th unit of labor plus 600 units of capital, there is 20% change in input and 20% change in output. It means this is known as constant returns to scale. And after this, percentage increase in input is more than percentage increase in output. And it is known as decreasing returns to scale. The reason for operation of long run law is economies and diseconomies of scale. What are these economies and diseconomies will be discussed in our next lecture with the topic cost and its various types, as we are going to close it right now. What we have till now is meaning of production and four factors of production, isoquants, production function and laws applicable in short run and long run. There is a difference between short run law and long run law. That is, there is a difference between law of variable proportions and law of returns to scale. First is applicability. Law of variable proportions are applicable in short run, whereas law of returns to scale are applicable in long run. Second difference is on the basis of variability of factors. Under law of variable proportions, only one factor is variable, that is labor is variable. But under the law of returns to scale, all factors are variable, that is no factor remains fixed. Third difference is on the basis of factor proportion. Factor proportion changes in short run, but factor proportion remains constant under the law of returns to scale. So, students, we will meet again in our next lecture. Till then, thank you.